is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
As always, we like to come to you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
Well, we just had the... Can't do it sometimes and not do it others. We got to either do it all the time or not do it at all. Anyway, the Mr. Federal Reserve came out with his minutes of the last meeting, and they said that they have a strengthening case for a rate cut. Saw a lot of widgets, nabobs, out saying that they needed a half a point in the next meeting. I don't think you're going to get that. But certainly a quarter point in the next meeting, and after that, we shall see. I think at this point, if we are expecting a rapid decrease in the rates, I think you're probably whistling up the wrong tree. And again, I will win the award for mixed metaphors. That's pretty much it. I'm looking through it and seeing what we had here, but there isn't a lot other than the fact that everybody's worried about potential issues with trade, which to this point, I would have thought I was going to be living in a mud hut if I listened to CNBC. But I don't think it's that big of a deal, as we said before. To me, I just think we're kind of getting in front of earnings, which probably not going to be a whole lot better than last quarter or the quarter before that. My guess is they kind of come in flat, and just pushing the market up before that, I think, has the cart before the horse just a little bit too much. Anyway, we'll see how the market tracks in. There's not a lot of juice, I think, to go higher. In fact, in a couple of days, if we reverse course today, I think you're going to see a lot of stocks that actually have put in some fairly decent and significant highs. That doesn't mean we go to hell in a handbasket. It just means that we probably need to pull back, gain some strength, and it may even take till next fall. The next big leg up in this market's going to happen with a announcement of a trade deal and the easing of tensions. Of course, we still have a little bit of a hangover with the Iranians. Every 5 minutes, they say they're going to attack us, and of course, they don't. So we don't know about that. But of the things that we know about, that's basically it. Trade and the Iranians saying they're going to bump us off. But they've been saying that for the last 40 years, hating on the Jews, and didn't seem to have gotten them very far. What else do we got? That's it. Up 15 on the S&P cash, 103 on the Dow. NASDAQ's up 57 points. Even the lowly Russell up 4.5 points. When we look at other things going on in the market, we look at oil back up to $60 again on a little bit on that Iranian deal. Gold's up 1470 to 1415. When we look at how trading has gone today so far, about 3.8 billion shares. So, again, we pushed higher once again and didn't have a lot of juice, especially after the, what would you call it, euphoric view of lower interest rates by Chairman Powell before the market opened. I don't think that there's a great deal to speak about. Dollar's down 43.44 cents. Other than that, I don't know if you can say. We got on there. I think everybody's already got a 25 point rate hike in for the next meeting. I think it's a lot more about what they say there. And again, we're about 7-8 days away from earnings. And it just seems to me like while we're kind of close to that high, everybody's getting a little euphoric and probably the cart before the horse a bit. My thinking is we do pull back and then take a big run at it this fall. You can call me at 877-927-6648. You can email me at path@tfnn.com. And, of course, you can always put a message in the den. Question, please tell us what you've seen in options market, equity, short, say, selling these days. Absolutely nothing. And that's why I'm worried. There's no real sign of higher prices, no real sign of lower prices. But the market with very light volume is brittle. And if I was a betting man, I would think that the big move would not be to the upside, but be to the downside. And, of course, a lot of people say, well, you know, the market's going higher. Well, it may go 10 points higher, and it may go 10 points higher with an 80% probability. But what if it goes 50 points lower on a 20% probability? Which way should you put your money? Are you willing to strike out a few times to make more money? What if it was 10 to 1? And that's where you get into the options. But as far as I'm concerned, we've come up here. We're kind of gasping for breath. All it needs, or all we do need, is one big surprise in the market. I think we could pull back about 50 points in the S&P cash. We need to get a lot of people bearish that they are not now to set up the next low. And that's what I'm hoping for. But I cannot guarantee. Of course, we can't guarantee anything in the markets. But we can guarantee I will do a little history.
That it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
And what do we have? History today. On this day in 1962, the world's first international communications satellite, Telstar 1, is launched into orbit. Collaboration between the U.S., Britain, France, and Telstar 1 introduced the world to transatlantic video feeds and ushered in a new area of communications. Of course, it didn't last long. By September, Telstar 1 was a dead satellite, and there was a very interesting reason for that. We had developed nuclear weapons, and we couldn't find anything else to bomb on the planet, so we started blowing up outer space. And there was a project called Operation Starfish, and I think it was like in the first week of September of that year. They blew it up. They blew one up over Hawaii, causing massive damage to the electrical grid, but also blowing away the first international satellite. And well, they launched one about 6 months later. Now, almost all satellites are built with a different substrate other than silicon, and that does a lot better with radiation and EMP fluxes. Of course, all the airplanes, all other things like tanks, all made with other things other than silicon. But on this day in 1962, they blew it up.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the Trade Matrix, the ETF Heat Grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $197 a month with the risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we're back to checking in on the market, which is pretty much in progress over most of all of TFNN's network. Down a little bit, up 13 points is what I show. Let's see what they have. Up 13 points on the S&P cash. 3,000, a little bit of resistance. But to me, I think it's not so much that we've got some kind of high blow-off. I just suspect that we've got a kind of a wind-up into the next 7 days, and there's not a lot to push us higher. And again, there aren't a lot of people that are short. So again, like I said, the risk reward is, 80%, we probably go 10 points higher. And there's always that 20% chance that we go extremely lower. And I'm always one to look at the odds and go for the big odds if they're within reason. Give me a call at 877-927-6648. Email me at path@tfnn.com or put a message in the den. Let's go through the biggies here real quick and see how they're doing on this news. Microsoft, a little spike out here. Again, we're looking for some double repo patterns as we did in May. We are very close to that in the Microsoft. Mr. Softy, as some people call him. What you look for in the double repo pattern is 10 to 15 days, something like that, above a 3x3 displaced moving average. That's taking the last 3 days, averaging them and putting them 3-day trading days into the future and drawing a line with it. It's not that far off from a 9-day moving average. It's just a little bit more reflective, a little faster than 9-day. It's got a little different. I just like it better. For Microsoft, we go to the 5th of June. So you got 5th being your first day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And, of course, you close back down it on the 15th day. That's on the 25th of June. You spend 4 days going sideways. You're back above it. Now we've got kind of a little doji out here on the top. Now, the sell signal, I think I'd be shorting other stocks other than Microsoft. But the sell signal would be any close now that is back below this. So all you need is a dollar or so, and that suggests that this will pull back to about 128. And I don't think that the market has to go to hell in a handbasket. Just markets go higher and markets go lower. It's not always fire and rain, but that's close. So if you're wanting to watch one stock throughout the end of the day and into the next few days, watch for this one. It's a pretty good signal. Again, I think that there are much lower hanging fruit to short, but you're kind of close out here, and I don't think you're going to retire on shorts on Microsoft, but it's interesting. Let's take a look at it. Intel, as we talked about this one, it doesn't have quite the signal that Microsoft does, but I don't think it really did much of anything. You're basically holding around here, not able to break through the 3x3 over the last couple of days. So there's no real energy in that. Let's take a quick look at Amazon. Okay. Amazon continues to move higher. Volume could be worse, but it still isn't good. Breaking through the 6.4 million share, made third high today. That was 1964. Yeah, 6.4 million shares. Yesterday you had 4.4 million shares. Today you've got 3.8 million shares so far. I don't think you're going to get anywhere close to the 6 million shares. Again, these are the go-to stocks, and everybody wants to buy them. I'm not going to jump up and down about shorting these. Netflix actually looks fairly good in the fact that your risk reward's pretty low about being short Netflix. A lot of discussion today about the at least big shows like The Office and Friends and Seinfeld and those kind of things. There is now a lot of these big corporations holding anything that they own like that to be put on their particular streaming business. And again, haven't seen a lot on Netflix that really makes me think that they've got a whole lot of new projects that are really great. Netflix made the model, showed how it would work, but the top tier talent now has a lot of place to go to, so that's spread out. You got a lot of B and C team movies, and the actual budgets have gone down, although the amount of content has gone up. Netflix also spending a lot of money sparingly across a lot of comedians because it's a very easy way to make content. You can make something for maybe $150,000 or $200,000. Couldn't even start to make a movie for that. And that gives your viewers, at least at Netflix and Amazon, same kind of thing, something to say that you do have new things coming out. Now, it's been a staple of HBO for a long time. Their comedy specials have been around since the 80s with George Carlin. But a lot of discussion out here. I think that Netflix probably fairly close to seeing some significant downside just for the combination of content and the fact that they're continue to spend a lot of money in foreign markets, and that is not paying off for them, at least from what I can tell. Okay. First email of the day comes in and says, they want to look at IBM. Has anything changed? And the answer is no. This one was right at resistance the last few days. Closed under the 3x3 yesterday. Closing under the 3x3 again today. My guess would be that the first target for the downside would be about 134. But for $6, I don't see a reason to go after that one. There are some better, like I said, low-hanging fruit. Restoration Hardware, a favorite of John from Philadelphia. Very interesting, keeping an eye on there. I haven't looked at what is the short interest on this. I will pop it up, though. Okay. Well, yesterday there was a bunch. It's been fairly low. Still got 31% short interest on the last reporting period. That was on 6/15. And we should be getting, today's the 10th. And we should be getting that in the next day or so. Wonder if that's actually available yet. And let's take a quick look here. I'll see. I don't think that they can. It either comes out today or tomorrow. I'll check that during the break. But we should get a new bi-monthly reading on shorts on all these stocks, probably released today or tomorrow. Let's take a look at that during the break. We'll be back.
Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Hi folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back. Let me turn that up a little bit so I can hear myself. What do we have? Oh, hey, we were talking about Restoration Hardware. Not as clear, but certainly bucking this huge down day, which was 13.3 million shares back on the 29th of March. You got into it, you know, you couldn't even get a million shares. Does have a 34% short interest on it. So you want this thing to spike and run everybody out one day and then pull the trigger. So, you know, ideally the most bearish thing that could happen is that you get a spike maybe up to 130, 133, maybe even 140, and not a lot of volume, and the shorts give up, and they capitulate, and then that's it. But, discussion, can you get it back to $60? And I don't really don't see anything. I see the big gap out there. I think, you know, if you are making a play, the risk reward would be to take this back to 80, which is where the next first. You got a nice gap down here from 110 to 95. And, of course, right now you're bucking the one on the uptrend. I don't see a lot of happening on this one. I need to go into the stores. I know they've got a big one here in Tampa and check it out. But does kind of seem like it is up on air. But, again, that 34% short interest is what you want to watch for. I did not see the short interest for this month published yet, but my guess is it'll be tonight or tomorrow night. They are pretty good at kind of holding off for us peons and not letting us see that much. They've raised the rate for actually getting the data. New York Stock Exchange will charge you $6,000 a month. Get short data. If you're an individual, you can get about that for about $6,000 a year, which seems rather expensive for something they probably should be telling us anyway. Question is Micron a blow-off top? And the question is probably close to being answered. 41 million shares into 40 million, well, 39 million shares on April 3rd. He had 84 million shares on March 21st, 85. And that's where you're kind of finding this fairly nice market in the fact that everybody's discounting their video cards, NVIDIA and AMD. So Micron makes three-fourths of its money, and probably close to that, selling video or VRAM and other memory for PCs, but mostly high-end stuff. They don't sell a lot of low-margin stuff, which is fairly nice. And, of course, the problem with that is it's always feast or famine. Let's take a quick look at NVIDIA and see if we see anything in there. I don't see a lot. You bounced. You got your 50% retracement up to 173.95. You're back to medium or minor support here at 155 from yesterday. Bounced a little bit today, but my guess is that you want to see this thing retest the 132.60. And again, if you missed it yesterday, I was talking about AMD really going to town against its major competitors, Intel and NVIDIA, in dropping, you know, they're basically number two. Remember that ad? Was it Avis? We have to try harder. We're number two. They're number two bananas in both Intel, behind Intel and NVIDIA. Both of them have the lion's share of the market. But they're getting quite competitive in both markets. The one thing that kills me is that there is no machine learning edge to AMD, and I don't know why. But I can't buy any of their video cards and expect to run any of my machine learning stuff on it and get it accelerated. And again, much better support for NVIDIA cards for compressing video. If you're a YouTuber and you're uploading lots of videos every day and compressing them, much better support from NVIDIA than AMD. But if you're just a gamer, a pretty decent product, maybe 95% as good as Intel, maybe 90% as good as NVIDIA, but maybe it's 70% the cost. And again, I don't know if it's going to do a lot for AMD, but it probably should continue to put pressure on Intel and on NVIDIA. Okay. Someone brought up Google. Let's take a quick look at that. Google has its own problems. We talked about it before I went on vacation, and that is it's real hypocrisy toward its contributors on YouTube. And, of course, a lot of the stuff that they do in Europe where, you know, it's covered up over here in the media. But they pretty much are flogging it over there with fines. And, of course, Google, what do they have beginning of the summer? A $5 billion fine? Pretty soon you fine somebody $5 billion. Eventually you get their attention. It's kind of like why the old parable of hitting the jackass, the actual mule, with a 2x4, and that's so you get its attention. Little pop-up here, no volume. I got a question here about Google. What do you mean about their hypocrisy? Google and YouTube have lots of movies. And in those movies, they violate almost all of what they say are the tenets of being on YouTube. So they can do it, but the people that are contributors can't. That's why I'm saying that why it's kind of interesting to think that they can pay or produce a movie for $30 million that has 300 F-bombs in it. But just let one poor sucker that makes $100 on his YouTube channel a month say the F-bomb and that's it. And that's why I'm saying a lot of these, and they're screwing them over for money. Now, they can always do that. I just suspect that one of two things. One, this thing really never made money as the way that they said it did. Or two, this is the only place they can wring more cash out is at the expense of the contributors. I just suspect there's going to be a lot of them that decide that it's just not worth the hassle. Most of the big contributors that I subscribe to on YouTube talk about it probably too much, but most of them are talking about going off YouTube and going to Patreon or some of the other ways of getting cash into it. So Google, as I call them, the child molesters of free speech, but for those people that try to earn a living on it, they are worse. Vago on continuous acquisition spree for years. Most recently, Semantic. Before that, Vago on communities. Okay. Yeah, we'll talk about that when we come back. But basically, like some of the giant biopharma stocks that just kept buying stocks to cover up and paper over the issues below. We'll talk about that when we come back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com. educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we were talking about Avago. No one really knows what's in the books of one of these big companies unless you've got private investigators and people willing to rat them out inside the company. That's kind of been illegalized now with a few new laws. But Avago continues to have massive acquisitions. Doesn't really seem to make that much money. Just from a spectator, it looks a lot more like Valeant Pharmaceuticals, where one day you're going to find out that these guys were all smoke and mirrors. The question is, you know, when's the wheels going to fall off the wagon on these things? And the answer is always the same, whether it's Enron or any of the others that have come after them. The answer is when the market turns down significantly enough, as William Buffett says, you can see who's swimming without a bathing suit. And it basically takes to that point. We wouldn't have known about the giant fraud with the hedge fund for $50 billion unless the housing debacle blew him up in 2008. That's the way of the world, and that is when the tide goes down, you see all the boats that sank, or maybe even sank for insurance money, laying on the floor of the ocean, and that's kind of it. So can it pull back? Do I think that anything right now has a big signal on it? The trade deal, at least in smartphones, gets really, really rugged, you might be able to see something in Avago, but much tougher to see on that. But to me, I don't know anything about the internals. I just know how much money, and it looks like the companies that do continuous acquisitions to keep revenue numbers moving higher, generally always ski out past the tips of their skis, eventually get involved in a little bit of accounting fraud, and eventually, like Valeant, somebody's go to jail. But I don't know when that is, and I have no inside information as to how bad the books are for Avago. There's a quote that I put in occasionally in the den, and that is that all books are either gently roasted or completely barbecued. I don't know. Again, I'm not a forensic accountant, and even if I was, these guys get to spend 40 hours and years in legal school in showing how to cover that stuff up. So you're never really going to know until the proverbial cow exhaust hits the spinning aluminum fan. Okay, what else do we have? We were looking at a few of these. BRCM. Okay, take a quick look at Twitter. of course, always in the news, and in the news today is that the freshman congressman from New York that hits the news quite regularly can't get rid of her followers on the heels of the exact same thing for the president. And I'm wondering if you can't get rid of the trolls, or at least downplay them enough, if Twitter actually has a future at all. This has always been one of the ones that has been problematic at best. Too many videos from people inside the company showing their political bias, that they're not in to make money, but to see how much they can manipulate public discourse, which, of course, doesn't make them much of any money. I just think this one and Facebook eventually are all going to have some rude awakenings. But again, just like Avago, until the market starts turning down these things, the weaknesses don't really show up. And they don't show up at the highs. People on Wall Street see the cracks at the highs. They know the weaknesses. They took these companies public. They know where the bodies are buried. But the whole point of this is to get the stock as high as you can, sell out all the shares you have, distribute them, and then let everybody know about the big problems in the company. But I think Twitter may be getting close to having its day, like every dog. sounds like a good night for the guys at J.P. Morgan. Okay, so we're at...
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're back. Had a little bit of an issue here technically, but we're back on it again. Up just a little under 11 points now. Dow on the S&P 500. Dow up 65. NASDAQ up 47. And Russell up 4, but pretty quiet. We'll check back in here on the dollar and see if we have anything else. And 38 cents. We were at what? Minus 45 cents. Now minus 38 cents. When we look at the rest of the market for volume, pretty weak going into these new highs. Probably wanted at least 9 to 12 billion shares today. We're hitting about 4.3 billion. So, not much on the upside. Certainly, there is no juice in it. We can continue to look at some of these other markets for guidance. But just so far, I don't see a lot. One thing that kind of interests me more than anything is the IYT. This couldn't really blow through the 190 area. He got up to 190, 148, turned back into this trading range. Certainly looks to me like this now, with any kind of volume over the next few days, would be setting up a pullback to about 175. That probably wouldn't be very good for most. What else do we have? Handful of stocks moving higher. A question about Tesla before we leave for the day. And I'm still thinking, 245, 250, 255. Just like Restoration Hardware, these highly shorted stocks, you want a spike to take out all the weak hands. And at a point, you get something like 15 or 20 point move higher on a down day, too, which is generally drives people that are short these things to the moon. But imagine this thing, let's say the NASDAQ's down 100 points tomorrow, but Tesla's up 15. That's the kind of thing that makes a high in these highly shorted stocks. You want a counter trend move if you can get it, short and sweet, and then by the end of the day, it gives it all back up. That's generally the best way to get rid of shares is, and the easiest way, if you're long a stock and you're an operator on Wall Street, is just run the thing up and the weakest hands that are short will get out. You can sell your stock and then you're probably not going to get it all back, but it's an easy way to dump a lot of shares. Look for phony articles about Tesla turning lead into gold, that kind of stuff, that just on the surface are rather pale. We've had a few of those the last couple of days in Tesla. You want something a little bit more egregious and something that you can't really even start to believe. But the euphoric Tesla bag holders will keep. Like I said in the last few weeks, after I covered the short on Tesla from 345-ish, where we started shorting it in the Tech Insider, this could take another 3 or 6 months to go sideways before it goes down. But Restoration Hardware, Tesla, a lot of these stocks that are highly shorted, right now at highs, you just really have to hope that you get those spikes that take out the weak hands and that you can also pull the trigger when that happens. Let's see what else we have if we go to it. Well, that's about it. I hear the music, so we're about done for the day. Again, sell when you can, not when you have to. We will see you here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time. Thank you.